Okay, hello everyone. Let us continue the lesson, motion in a plane. Do you remember? The motion of an object on the surface is termed as a motion in a plane. Or to locate the position of object out of three coordinate system, any two coordinate system can be used. Okay, so there are three concepts we have discussed, we are supposed to discuss in this lesson. One was scalar and vectors, that we have learnt in the last video. Another one is projectile motion, and one more circular motion. In fact, projectile motion and circular motion are examples of what? Two-dimensional motion. Okay, so now let us focus on the article projectile motion. See, first of all, some terminology we will learn over here. First terminology is what is a projectile. See, first of all, projectile is the body thrown into space, and after throwing into space it is allowed to fall freely under gravity. Please remember, projectile is the name given to the body which is thrown into the space and allowed to fall freely under gravity. And one more thing, the motion of such a body means in this situation, the motion of a body can be called as what? Projectile motion. Generally, all projectile motions are influenced by whom? That is acceleration due to gravity. Okay. So the best example for projectile motion are a missile launched. When a missile is launched, have you seen how the missile propagates in the form of a parabolic form, parabola? A missile launched describes what? A parabolic path, in the sense projectile motion. And have you seen an object dropped from a moving aeroplane? When object is dropped from a moving aeroplane, just see, it also describes a curved path, or what is known as a projectile path. Okay, so another very important example is when you are have you seen an athlete performing a long jump? Okay, when an athlete performs a long jump, he also uses the concept of what? Projectile motion. And who is responsible for such a pattern of motion? That is acceleration due to gravity. Okay, see one more time, what is a projectile? It is the body thrown into the space and allowed to fall freely under gravity. So examples of a projectile motion, bullet fired from a gun. A bullet fired from a gun. Have you seen its motion? It is nothing but projectile motion. One more example. A missile launched from the ground. Okay, these are best example for what? Projectile motion. And one thing you remember always, who influences the projectile motion is acceleration due to gravity. In the sense, if you are say in outer world, that is in the space, outer world, or in the space, when object is thrown, so there no gravity, therefore the path of object in space or inside the satellite would be a straight line. Why? Because over there what is absent? Acceleration due to gravity. This simple example illustrate the fact that who influences the projectile motion on the surface of the earth? It is acceleration due to gravity. Okay, so now we will go for some other concepts, especially equation of a projectile. This is important for 5 marks also. As far as theory is concerned, the derivation you need to practice. First of all, for a projectile motion, already we have discussed projectile motion is an example of what? Two-dimensional. But how to represent a two-dimensional motion using two coordinate system? Agree? So, let us move on to this interesting article. The name of article is Equation of a Projectile, or sometimes they may ask the same article in this way also. Show that path of a projectile. Listen to the idea. Show that path of a projectile is a parabola. Parabola is a conic section actually. You will learn equation of parabola in your mathematics as under the heading called conic sections. Not only parabola, you will learn ellipse. Okay. See, equation of a projectile, or sometimes they may frame this article as show that the path of projectile is a parabola. First of all, already we have discussed projectile motion can be considered as a two-dimensional motion. So, what is two-dimensional motion? This, it is a combination of two independent motion along a straight line only. So, what we did in motion in one dimension, please? We have analyzed motion with any one reference axis. Now we are analyzing the same motion with the two reference axes, that is preferably x and y. So the two independent one dimensional motion, when they are clubbed, that itself becomes what? Two dimension. Means over here you will have two independent motion, analysis of the same object in the two independent reference axes, that is x as well as what? Why? So now see, first point is clear. In projectile motion, how we represent projectile motion with the two coordinate system. Okay. So an object was given an initial velocity. Let us say u is the initial velocity at an angle what? Theta with the horizontal. And it is projected. This u is called velocity of a projectile, whereas theta is called angle of projection. So, with reference to the horizontal, an angle theta was chosen and it is projected with what? Initial velocity u. And it is allowed to fall under gravity. So, what it does? It describes such a path and falls over here. Okay. While describing this path at this region, the projectile has reached the maximum vertical height. This is called maximum height. Okay. So now the analysis of motion of object in this case is with reference to how many axes? Two axes, that is x as well as y. That is the reason why here your velocity has two components. I think earlier you have learnt resolution of a vector. Can you recall that article, please? How you resolve a vector along horizontal? If a vector was chosen as r, how you have taken its component along horizontal? R cos theta. What is its component along y axis, please? R sin theta. Similarly, your velocity has two components. Why two components? Because what type of motion projectile describes? Two dimension. Therefore, here velocity of projectile has two components. One is along the horizontal. What is that velocity? U cos theta. And another one is along what? U sin theta. Okay. So at any instant, sir, I want its velocity, instant velocity at this instant. What I should do? A tangent have to be drawn over here. Okay. When you draw a tangent, you will get the velocity of projectile at this point. Okay. But how to resolve it? Very simple. this is along vertical and this is along horizontal, because in this projectile always how many components of velocity? A projectile is said to have two components. One is horizontal component, other one is vertical component. And here horizontal component is Vx and vertical component is Vi. What is this resultant? How to find resultant, please? Laws of vector addition. Can you recall that laws of vector addition? V is equal to what? Under root of Vx square plus Vy square. Agree? So, at any instant, what you are seeing over here, this velocity has how many components? Two components, horizontal and vertical. Interestingly, when a projectile describes this path, that is a projectile path we say, and there is a name given to the projectile path. Anybody knows the name given to the projectile path? The name given for the projectile path was trajectory. What is trajectory? Means the path of a projectile is called a trajectory. So let me clarify, how is the trajectory for a projectile? It is a parabola. How is the trajectory for a object thrown into the space? That is a straight line. Did you got the point? Trajectory refers to what? Path traced by whom? Projectile. It may be parabola or it may be straight line, but totally it is a path traversed by whom? A projectile. Okay. At any instant, what is happening? The projectile has two components of velocity. So what is happening when the object describes a projectile path? Its vertical component of velocity was found to be decreasing, and when it reaches to the maximum height, what was observed is its vertical component turned to zero. But interestingly, actually your projectile has how many components of velocity? Two. And in projectile you will observe among the two components of velocity, one component of velocity shows some variation. And how about the other component of velocity? It not shows any variation. Means it throughout the journey, the value of that component of velocity remains the same. That is what the beauty of projectile. Agree? So here, when we are reaching the maximum point, the vertical component of velocity becomes zero. But how about the horizontal component? It remains the same. Not only remains the same, whatever value it has in the beginning, the same value over here, u cos theta. Are you getting the idea? So now onwards, remember, a projectile motion is an example of two-dimensional motion. And in a projectile motion, at any instant, how many components the projectile components of velocity? A projectile has two components. Among those two components, which component of velocity subject to change? Vertical component. Which component of velocity remains the same throughout the journey? Horizontal component. And how the vertical component of velocity changes, please? Initially, it has a high value. When it reaches to the maximum, the value decreases, and at the highest point, it becomes zero. Remember, only vertical component of velocity becomes zero. But how about horizontal? Whatever value horizontal component has in the beginning, throughout the journey, the value is not going to change. Okay. So at the highest point, what is happening to vertical component of velocity? Attaining zero. Now after that, when it descends down, what happens to the horizontal? Once again same. But what is happening to vertical component of velocity? It is increasing. When it is about to touch the ground, it will attain the same value as it has in the beginning. Means the velocity with which a particle projected upward, it will descend with the same velocity. This is what happening to whom? Vertical component of velocity. Now onwards, remember, in a projectile motion, which component of velocity is subject to change? That is vertical component of velocity. Which component of velocity remains the same? That is horizontal. Let us discuss the same with the numbers. think that you have a vertical component of velocity as 3 meter per second and horizontal as 4 meter per second. When path of the projectile is along O to A, what is happening to 3 meter per second? It is goes on decreasing, but horizontal I took it as 4 meter, it will remain the same. When you are at the highest point, what is 3 meter turns to 0, but what is happening to 4 meter? That is same. So at any instant, sir, I am here. So you can resolve again like this. Agree? What is this component of velocity, please? Horizontal. What is this component of velocity? Vertical. And one more thing. Here, which component of velocity is changing its value, please? Vertical. Do you remember? Whenever velocity changes are happening, what is said to be produced? An acceleration. Agree? But for a horizontal component, is there any acceleration aspect? No. Because throughout the journey, what is happening to horizontal component? Keeping same value. So therefore, is there any acceleration? Definitely. Due to whom? The change in vertical component of velocity value. So that acceleration, where it is acting? It is always acting in a direction, what we call as a vertically downwards, wherever you are. If you are over here, again the vertically downward. Please remember, at any course of journey, the direction of acceleration is vertically downwards. So who is affecting your velocity? It is acceleration due to gravity. Which velocity component? Only vertical. Please remember, your horizontal component of velocity is not been affected by whom? Gravity. That is the reason why you can enjoy this horizontal component for describing what a parabolic path. And of course, both are important, but this will enable you to move in a horizontal pattern. So this is what the projectile analysis. I think we have got a clear idea. So let us summarize. The projectile motion is an example of what a two-dimensional motion, in the sense here two reference axes are chosen to locate the position of object. And here when an object was given an initial velocity at an angle theta with the horizontal and that is been allowed to fall under gravity, what is the path the projectile set to trace? A trajectory. And now you are supposed to prove that trajectory is a parabola. So among the two components of velocity, which component of velocity is subject to change? It is a vertical component. Which component of velocity remains the same throughout its journey? That is horizontal. And what is special point? What is the velocity of a projectile at the highest point? Please remember, about at the highest point, vertical component of velocity is zero, but horizontal component is not zero. Remember. Now, how to obtain the equation for a projectile? First of all, as I said, projectile motion can be analyzed as a two independent one-dimensional motion. Agree? Now your particle has some distance coverages along horizontal direction. Logically, the same particle has some distance coverages along vertical direction also. Let me one more time clarify the same idea. Whenever particle or projectile describes a projectile motion, is it not it is covering some distance along horizontal, that is along x-axis? There is a one more at the same time as said, there is a distance coverages along a vertical also. What do you mean by vertical? Along y-axis. What is meant by horizontal? Along x-axis. Let us discuss one by one. Distance along horizontal. Okay, let us select a point P here at a distance x. Okay, I have chosen a point P at a distance x, that is along horizontal. So now tell me, you have learnt to calculate distance coverages of the particle with uniform velocity as well as with uniform accelerated motion also. If it is moving with uniform velocity, what is the distance coverage formula? Velocity into time. If it is having accelerated aspect to cover the distance, what is the distance coverages? Half at square. Please do recall those idea. So distance along horizontal is due to what? Uniform velocity. When it is uniform velocity, let us take x is equal to velocity into time. Which component of velocity, please? Horizontal. U cos theta into t. Therefore, what is time is equal to x by u cos theta. As I said, projectile can be analyzed as two independent one-dimensional motion. Later on, we can club and combine a single equation, combine to get a single equation. Now, what is the interpretation here? I have analyzed its motion along horizontal. Now, the distance coverages along vertical. Along vertical. Very simple. First of all, what is the distance? Let us take y. And with what velocity it is moving along vertical? U sin theta, because along horizontal is u cos theta, whereas vertical is u sin theta. Then is it going against the gravity? Yes. Then anything else? Okay, this is the concept. So keep the diagram please in your mind. Shall we move on to the next step? See, S is equal to Y, vertical component is U sin theta, acceleration due to gravity is minus G. What is the formula? S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Agree, S is Y. U, which component of velocity for this discussion? Vertical component into time minus half GT square. Agree? Right, please. Now look at the equation 1. Is it not equation 1 and equation 2 are talking about the same particle in motion? Can you recall? Is it not equation 1 and 2 are talking about the same particle or different particle? Same particle. What does it mean? Whatever time expression shown over here, is it not in the same time here also the expression of time is valid? Why? Because the particle is same. So what I can do? Put equation 1 in 2. Are you seeing here please? I am giving the reason why I have to substitute 1 in 2. Because whatever time expression we have in the first equation, in the same time, the second equation also describing its expression along the y direction. In the sense, the same time value can be substituted here. The reason is particle is same. So y is equal to u sin theta into time value x by u cos theta. Just see carefully. G, time value x by u cos theta. Next step is simple. Square root of c plus. Any idea? Sin theta by cos theta, trigonometry, that is tan theta minus gx square. Agree please? 2 u square cos square theta. Sorry. This is a equation of the form. In mathematics, you will learn this is of the form. There is an equation in mathematics. This is equation of a parabola. Is it not? The equation resembles the same. Here x replaced by x, whereas constant is tan theta. The x square is x square only, but constant is g divided by 2 u square cos square theta. What does it mean? When the expression we derived appears in the form of this standard equation, do you know what is this standard equation represent? It is equation of parabola. You will learn these aspects in your mathematics, okay? This is of the form A is y is equal to x minus bx square, which is a parabola. Hence, now we can conclude the path of a projectile is a parabola. Agree? So this is how you can arrive at the equation of what projectile. Just see carefully. So one thing is important, who influences the projectile motion? It is acceleration due to gravity. And what is the velocity of a projectile at the highest point? It is zero. Which component of velocity in a projectile motion changes? Vertical component. Which component of velocity remains the same? That is horizontal. Okay, these are the very important points. You need to note it down. Okay. See, related to projectile motion, three more derivations you need to practice. One is expression for maximum height of a projectile. Second one is time of flight of a projectile. Third one is range of a projectile. Okay. So, these expressions as well as their derivations are also important as far as the theory exams were concerned. And you need to practice the expression also for your objective interactions. Okay. See, first of all, related to projectile motion only, let us derive an expression for a maximum height. First of all, we must know what is maximum height. See over here, please. Once again, projectile motion diagram. This is the projectile motion. Do you remember who influences the projectile motion? Of course, the acceleration due to gravity. Okay. So, which component of velocity subject to change? Vertical component. This is your initial velocity. How many components of velocity your projectile has, please? Two components. When you are over here, okay, that is at the highest point. How many components at any instant projectile must and should have? Two components, agree? This is a V stands for the velocity of projectile after time t. Whereas this is also velocity of projectile after time t. But interestingly, for projectile, even in the initial phase or at any instant, your velocity component along horizontal is the same. That is u cos theta. Okay. This is zero. And this is called the maximum height. So, what is maximum height? The maximum vertical height attained by the projectile is called the maximum height. Let me repeat. The maximum vertical height reached by the projectile is called maximum height. Okay. So now let us derive an expression for maximum height. We have to discuss only vertical concept for this place, because height is related to which pattern of motion? Vertical pattern of motion. Okay. So now, what is the initial velocity, please? Initial velocity along vertical, I am asking, which is u sine theta, correct? Vertical velocity along vertical. When you are at the highest point, what is the vertical component of velocity, please? Zero. Now, what is actually required? Distance. Here distance, vertical distance will have what expression? H. Now, are you moving towards gravity or against gravity, or generally how the G acts on you vertically downwards? Right. So now, any repetition? How to extract the data for this pattern of motion to arrive at maximum height? Very simple concept. Now, which is the formula? This is the formula. Do you know all equations of motions are valid for body projected vertical upwards as well as freely falling body? V square is equal to u square plus 2as. What is v, please? 0. U, the initial velocity of a projectile along vertical, minus 2gs. S is what? H. Therefore, 2gh is equal to u square sin square theta. Think, please, carefully. H is equal to, can you please, u square sin square theta divided by what? 2g. Just see. Now, what is your comment on this expression, please? The comment is, the maximum height attained by the projectile found to depend on two factors. One is angle of projection. I am talking about the value. Angle of projection as well as what? Velocity of velocity with which object is projected, or you can say simply velocity of projectile and angle of projection. Just see the expression. H is equal to u square sin square theta by 2g. Now, when this maximum height of a projectile attains maximum height, somewhat confusion. Okay, I am asking, when this maximum height expression reaches to maximum, very easy. If you take just an analysis, if you take theta as 90 degree, what is sine 90 degree, please? It is 1. You have expression u square sin square 90 degree by 2g. Therefore, when your height expression turns to maximum, when theta is 90. What do you mean by theta 90? The object is thrown perpendicular to the surface. If you want to make your object to reach maximum vertical height, so logically with what angle it has to be projected? 90 degree. A simple common sense based idea. Now, if I project along this, that is, if I take theta is equal to 0, means thrown along the horizontal. So, can I have any maximum height, please? No. Right? So, the maximum height is 0. Next concept. As I said, there are totally three derivations. One is maximum height, second one is time of flight, third one is range of projectile. Now we will move on to the another derivation. All derivations are important for the range 1 to 3 marks, please. Don't neglect. As far as the theory exams are concerned, time of flight, this is T. Okay. So, what is time of flight? It is the time taken to describe its trajectory. Just see. So, your projectile describes its trajectory and fall on the ground. Agree? So, this is the trajectory. O, A, B is what? Trajectory. Now, we have showed that trajectory is what? A parabola. So now the logically, even your projectile describes its trajectory to fall on the ground, it takes some amount of time. That time we refer as by what name, please? Time of flight. One more time. It is the time taken by the projectile to describe its trajectory. Now we have especially India has many missiles. Agni, Prithvi, do you know the range we have now? Agni almost reached 1400 kilometer range. Okay, so, and even you can calculate it, what time it may hit on the target. See, the time of flight means it is the time taken by the projectile, okay, to describe its trajectory. Right. Now we will derive an expression for time of flight. Now what we do? We analyze the time of flight in this way. For O to A, we call a time taken by the projectile as a time of ascent. Agree? When it is traveling from A to B, let us call this time as a time of descent. One important thing, if air resistance is neglected, what a scientist advise you to take? Time of ascent is equal to time of descent. Now, and interestingly, your time of flight is what? It is nothing but sum of time of ascent and time of descent. Agree? Because it covers the entire trajectory, no? I have divided the trajectory for O to A as a time of ascent and for A to B as time of descent. Therefore, logically, what is time of flight? It is sum of time of ascent and time of descent. And one more point I told, if air resistance is neglected, then what is the relation between a time of ascent and time of descent? They are equal. So now, for time of ascent, once again, how many components your projectile has? Please, two components. When you are at the highest point, what is this velocity component, please? Zero. What is this component? U cos theta. Okay, for a time of ascent, what is your initial velocity, please? U sin theta. Agree? And when you are reaching at the highest point, it is zero. Now you take time as what? Time of ascent. Are you moving towards gravity or against gravity? Always G acts vertically downward. So which relation supports, please? This one. So what is this? Zero. What is this? U sin theta minus G T of ascent. Now, can you simplify? Time of ascent is equal to what, please? U sin theta by G. Up to this is okay. Time of ascent is U sin theta by G. One more point, if air resistance is neglected, what a scientist have found? Time of ascent is same as time of descent. So what value it may have? U sin theta by G. This is also important. But actually, what is required for us? Time of flight. What is time of flight? It is the time taken by the projectile to describe its trajectory, or it is a sum of a time of ascent and a time of descent. Now, let us find the time of flight formula. Just see, please. Right. Time of flight is a sum of a time of ascent and time of descent, but the condition is air resistance neglected. So what happens if air resistance is considered? We will learn in the numericals. So which is equal to U sin theta by G plus U sin theta by G. Correct? So therefore, what is the answer, please? Now, can you comment on the expression, please? On what factor time of flight found to depend? Two factors: velocity of projectile and angle of projectile. So it is 2u sin theta by g. So please remember the definition as well as derivation. So one more. See, now range of projectile. So what is the range of projectile? See, it is the horizontal distance covered by the projectile during its what? Time of flight. This is your point of projection. This is what? Point of termination. and this distance, point of projection and point of termination along horizontal line is called range of projectile. Just now I was giving an idea. The government of India already had many missiles, that is Agni, and we have Prithvi, Brahmas, and recently they are upgrading the missiles. What do you mean by upgrading? Increasing the range. Now we have many surface to surface missiles. So one of our missile has a range 1400 kilometer. Now we are still improving the ranges of surface to surface missile, but already America already produced global missiles, means they have a huge range. If they project a missile from east end, it may reach the west end also, the entire diameter of the earth length. Just see, okay, see what is the range of projectile. It is the horizontal distance covered by the projectile during time of flight. Just see, it is the horizontal distance covered by the projectile at what time? During its time of flight. Okay, so now it is a horizontal distance, they said. So already you know how to calculate horizontal distances. Usually what is distance? Velocity into time. But when it is valid? When a body has a uniform velocity. But when you are using distance is equal to half at square, when it has uniformly accelerated motion. But what is happening for horizontal component of velocity? It is a uniform, no? Therefore, which formula would you suggest? So range, I can say range here corresponds to what? Horizontal distance. And who is covering horizontal? Which component of velocity covering horizontal distance? Vertical, horizontal. Range is equal to velocity into time. Which velocity? Horizontal component of velocity. Remember, velocity into time. Which time? Time of flight. Right. So just see, what is the range is equal to horizontal component of velocity into time of flight. Now see, range is equal to what? Velocity. Which component of velocity, please? Horizontal component of velocity into what? Time of flight. Okay, range is equal to what is horizontal component of velocity? U cos theta. Recall. Okay, time of flight 2u sin theta by g. Now look here, so it becomes u square. Okay, 2 times sin theta into cos theta by g. Any idea about the trigonometric formula? No idea. Sin 2 theta means what? Haven't you studied? Sin 2 theta means 2 sin theta into cos theta. Therefore, r is equal to u square sin 2 theta by g. This part. Okay, this is the expression for what? Range of projectile. And one more time, comment on this expression. Just see, is it not your range also depends on velocity of projectile as well as what? Angle of a projectile. Now when this expression, just see the expression please, u square sin 2 theta by g. When this expression attains a minimum value, when this expression attains a maximum value, just see. Star point for range is maximum. This is an important concept. Angle of projection must be what? 45 degree, because already 2 is there, no, in the expression sine of 2 theta, because sine 90 is the maximum. So R is equal to u square sine 2 theta, right? So this becomes what? U square sine 90 degree by g, okay? But what is sine 90, please? It is 1. Therefore, this expression we refer as a maximum range expression. Here is the formula. Remember, when the range of a projectile attains the maximum value, where angle of projection is 45 degree, okay, even if you want to go for a long jump, so it is better if you incline your body to an angle of 45 degree, you may win the game. There is a high chance, but only thing is you have to maintain 45 degree to have a maximum range, in the sense horizontal distance. So when this becomes minimum, R is, R means range, minimum, when theta is 0 degree, because sine 0 is 0, therefore range is what? Minimum. So one more thing, see, for what angles of a projection, CET concept or objective concept, for what angles of projection ranges are said to be equal? Just see, very important concept for objective. For the angles of projection, for the angles of projection, theta and just see, 90 minus theta means what? Sum of two angles of projection is equal to what? 90 degree. If this is the condition, then what we can see? For the angles of projection theta and 90 minus theta, the ranges are equal. Very interesting result. Are equal. Just see one more time. For what angles ranges are equal? Only for these angles, 90 and 90 minus theta. What does it mean? If one is 20 degree, other should be 70 degree. If one is 30 degree, other should be 60. In the sense, the sum of two angles of projection must be equal to what? 90 degree. So let us see. For theta, what is the range formula? U square sine 2 theta by g, this is your first angle theta. Now just analyze for the next angle, 90 minus theta. R2 is equal to u square sine of 2, 90 minus theta by g. Yes, R2 is equal to u square, what it is? 180 minus theta, theta is 2 theta here. So it is sine 180 minus theta, allied angles, which is u square sine 2 theta by g only. Just see, is it not, we have proved the fact, that is, for the angles of projection theta and 90 minus theta, what are going to be equal? Range, just see. R1 is equal to what? R2. Okay, this is how you have seen what are equations for projectile motion. Many equations you have seen. One is equation of projectile itself, that is y is equal to x tan theta minus gx square divided by 2 u square cos square theta, and you have seen expression for maximum height, h is equal to u square sin square theta by 2g. You have seen expression for time of flight, that is t is equal to 2u sin theta by g. You have seen range of projectile, that is r is equal to what? U square sin of 2 theta by g. Just look at them, please, expression, and even you need to practice the equation of projectile, and you need to practice the derivation of a maximum height expression. time of light as well as range. Okay.